Hippos have a formidable reputation. Across Africa, they kill around 500 people every year. Few filmmakers have attempted to capture their lives in detail. But director Brad Bestelink was determined to take up the challenge.
I was born to the Delta, brought into the swamp when I was 4 days old. I've always wanted to make a film about hippos in the Okavango, simply because they are pivotal to the way the whole Okavango itself functions.
With the best location for filming identified from the air, Brad and cameraman Mike Amos head out in the boat.
It's very difficult. You need to get really close to the animals underwater to be able to get the footage and understand what they're doing. But you don't want to get too close to them because they're that dangerous.
Brad has had personal experience of this when he once accidentally surprised a hippo.
He obviously got a hell of a fright when he saw us. He hit the side of the boat, threw us off. We caught him in the shallow. He felt vulnerable, lashed out.
All the gear on the boat just went to the bottom. I've just spent the last hour diving all this stuff out. Quite a frightening experience.
To avoid a similar situation, Brad hopes to plant a pole camera directly in a hippo's path.
See, there's a hippo there. There's a hippo there coming this way.
Okay, cool.
It's coming that way. Whoa, Mike. Roger. This is what we're after.
Now they need to set the camera as quickly as possible.
Where is he?
There's another one here somewhere. Okay, as soon as this is in, we've got to get the other side of him, eh?
Okay.
Let's go.
Camera in position, it's a waiting game.
You'd be amazed at how subtle a lot of the signs are of hippo. I mean, it's such a big animal, but it really just goes really quietly and doesn't spend too much time on the surface.
The hippos could be anywhere.
It's amazing that you can lose a hippo.
Research suggests that hippos can hold their breath for a maximum of 5 minutes. So after 10 minutes, Brad moves in to collect the camera. But the hippo is still there.
He's right here.
It seems that hippos can stay under the water much longer than anyone thought possible. Persisting with the pole cam pays off. Getting them some beautiful shots of the hippo in their underwater world. But Brad didn't want to stop there. He wanted a deeper insight, and that took a bit of creativity.
In our sort of pursuit to film hippos, we've had various iterations of cameras. We've had remote-controlled boats that hippos have eaten. We've got floating cameras, which every time a hippo moves, it tends to rock.
Even the underwater microphone became a curiosity. So Brad had to come up with something that had never been done before.
Basically, it's an underwater remote control car, and it's got to literally crawl its way through the sand and vegetation.
Time for a test run.
Look at that thing. Look at that thing.
Go find him, hippo.
With the test a success, they now need to place the camera near a hippo, a somewhat bigger challenge.
I'm just going to have a look at this pool and see if it's got the right entrance and the right current. I think we could
Anchor on it and send it down that channel.
Off he goes.
For days on end, they film nothing but fish.
The pod is very aware of where it is. Can't tell you the amount of hours I spent looking at this monitor into murky water and not seeing anything.
Looks like there's a couple fairly close by.
Oh, got a hippo right in the nose. He's coming, having a good look. Straight walking into it.
Ooh, what a shot.
See all the hairs, bristly hairs off his nostrils. Another one. Jeez, that's amazing.
For Brad, it's the culmination of a lot of hard work.
It's been sort of 4 years of trial and error. It's wonderful, really. You actually feel like you're in the water. It's sort of nerve-wracking having a hippo walk up to this little camera.
Capturing such intimate footage has given Brad a different perspective on these notorious animals.
Yeah, it's a big, dangerous animal, but they're also very sensitive, very skittish. I really think that aggressive man-killing animal is not an accurate reflection of what they are. I think that they're timid, sweet, intelligent, very sensitive animals.
These unique images wouldn't have been possible without Brad's knowledge of the Delta and determination to tell the hippo's story.
To protect them, you need to let people understand a different nature of them. They are ultimately intrinsically important to the functioning of the entire swamp.